You remember her as Little Grace Sheffield in The Nanny, oh, but she starred in plenty of other shows as an adult, from Heroes and Californication to Twin Peaks. Welcome, Madeline Zima. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, Dana?
It's so good to have you. So I was going back and reading, and I love this about you. You were very honest. You were talking about The Nanny, and you said you had been politically correct for a lot of years, but you had actually said it wasn't the best experience.
I did say that.
But actually, the way you explained it made a lot of sense to me. You were very young, and
yeah, I had worked on a lot of different stuff at that point. I mean, I had already done The Hand That Rocks the Cradle, and so I mean, I would like to, because that was supposed to be as well, like, off the record.
Right, right.
It's okay. It's
sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
I am grateful for The Nanny and the experience that it changed me as a person, but for the best. Like, I mean, I know so much about right. acting, mm-hmm. about story, about timing, and that's from Fran and watching her and watching everybody on the show be so brilliant. So
right.
I'm grateful for it, although there were some tough moments, just like everything in life.
Like most sets, though, I would say is probably the case. Okay, so you've been steadily working, like, in the last 20 years. I mean, like we talked about Twin Peaks, Californication, Heroes. Now you're in a thriller called Chain of Death, yeah. and I was watching it, and it's one of those that you get that instant feeling in your stomach, like you're uncomfortable, you're,
yeah.
you know, tell me about it.
Well, it's about a guy who has a neurological disease, and he signs up for an assisted suicide ring,
okay.
but that he has to kill someone in order to be killed. Oh. And it's a psychological thriller. And John Patrick Amadori is in it, and Ray Weiss, and Adrian Barbeau, and Jamie Clayton, and they're all wonderful. And it was an amazing experience. I love working with great actors and people who are really kind and generous.
I'm going to ask you about it and how you felt watching it in just a second, but I want you to take a look at Chain of Death.
Life insurance?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it'll be enough to keep you comfortable and, you know, I'm just trying to plan ahead, you know. You know, be an adult. Don't adults do this?
Are you sick?
No. No, not at all.
Then I'm not gonna pretend that this isn't awkward.
So I was talking to you before this, and she said she can't watch it. It's too scary for her.
Yeah, it really does an amazing job of keeping that tension really heightened all the way through. And I did watch it, and I will watch it again on Friday when it comes out. But it's a lot of anxiousness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
People love that, though. It does a great job of, you know, being a psychological thriller.
So you've done so many genres now. If you had to pick one, like if you had to pick one to stay with, what would you pick?
I like romantic comedy.
I do too.
I mean, because they make you feel good.
Right.
They bring
right.
hope into your world. Mm-hmm. A little bit of lightness and happiness. We could use that in this world right now. So, you know. A little bit of sunshine and joy.
I agree. Thank you so much. It definitely looks like a really good psychological thriller.
Thank you
so much for coming in. Chain of Death will be showing at Laemmle Music Hall in Beverly Hills Friday at 10 p.m. and it will be available on demand and digital platforms July 30th. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you, Dana. Thanks.